Keshar Vikramasinghe. In this channel, I'm going to give you small tutorials about YASA module lessons. And today I'm not going to give you any tutorials because I want to explain what is YASA and what is YASA Part 66 license modules. So please stick with me and please subscribe my channel to get more tutorials in future. And okay, let's move to the introductions. Okay, this is European Aviation Safety Agency logo, right? So now we will going to move YASA head office, and our office address is European Aviation Safety Agency, and postal address is that's address belong to Germany, and they have telephone numbers, fax numbers, email and website. Okay, then we will move to what is YASA Part 66. The European Aviation Safety Agency implementing a rule, Part 66, is the aviation regulations which define the conditions by which maintenance engineer is able to gain through company approvals authorizations to work on, certify and release an aircraft into service after a maintenance operation. It means this license belong to the persons who are going to work on aircraft and certify for the aircraft and also release for an aircraft. It means the person who is going to sign for CRS of an aircraft. Okay, now let's move to gateway to the aircraft maintenance engineering, right? Okay, so aircraft engineers are the backbone of the air travel and transport industry. They maintain the travel and make sure that the planes are fit and safe to fly. It means the aircraft engineers is really important role in aviation industry. Even pilots also cannot fly without engineers, right? Okay, so this is a aircraft maintenance license. This is an example. This is European Union and this is issued by Kingdom of Netherlands. This is the Part 66 aircraft maintenance license. Okay, so now we are going to move license categories. So license categories, they have four categories: category A, category B1, category B2 and category C. The category A is for the line mechanic. And category B1 mechanical technicians, and B2 avionic technicians, and category C based maintenance engineers. So category A line mechanic, they have some subcategories. They are called A1, A2, A3, A4. So A1 belongs to aeroplane jet engine, A2 belong to aeroplane piston engines, A3 belong to helicopter jet engines, and A4 belong to helicopter piston engine. So if you going to do some examinations, you can choose from which category you are going to get the license and you are going to work, right? So category B1 mechanical technicians, they also have the subcategories. It's called B1.1 aeroplane jet engines, B1.2 aeroplane piston engines, B1.3 helicopter jet engines, B1.4 helicopter piston engines. So for category B2 avionic technician, and category C belong to base maintenance engineer qualified to the B1 and B2 standard. Normally category C engineers are the persons who are going to sign for the CRS. For now we're going to move the rules of the examination. So the first 10 modules are common to all. Out of 17 modules, the first 10 modules are common for every person, right? So the persons applying for the Cat A license does not have to take the module 4. It means if you're going to apply for the Cat A license, you don't want to do the Cat module 4. And exact content of each module for the particular exams will vary depending on what license the engineer is aiming for. Okay, so once the first module examination is passed, a 10-year clock is set during which time all the experience must be obtained and all the modules passed. If they are not, you will start to lose the first module pass. It means you will get 10-year clock time once you sit for first module to get the license. If you get more than 10 years to get the license, then you have to start to do the first module again after 10 years. And almost no exceptions are allowed to any of the examinations, but holders of certain degrees may get exceptions to some of the modules. Check with the YASA. Okay, this is the examinations format. All basic examinations are multi-choice and questions. Multi-choice questions and format sub questions. It means you will get all MCQ questions and essay questions and objective questions. Average time allowed for question is 75 seconds, and each essay average time allowed is 20 minutes per questions. And module 7, 9 and 10 have essay questions. And about the pass mark for the all modules is 75%. If you get 74%, you will fail. And if either the multiple choice part only or the essay part only is fails, then it is only necessary to retake the multiple choice or essay part as appropriate. It means if you did multiple choice and essay, if you fail essay questions, you have to take again retake only the essay question. Okay, so then a fail module can be retaken after 90 days following the date of the fail module examination. Okay, let's move to modules. What are the types of modules are there? Okay, so the first module is mathematics. It's very easy. Category A, people have to face 16 MCQ questions and they will give 20 minutes. And category B1, 30 MCQ questions, time is 40 minutes. And category B2, 30 MCQ questions and time is 40 minutes. And module 2, physics, category A, 30 MCQ, they will give 40 minutes. B1, 50 MCQ, 60 minutes. And B2, 50 MCQs and from 65 minutes. And normally module 1 and module 2 have to do together because these two are kind of same. And then module 3, electrical fundamental, for the category A viewers, they don't want to do this one. And category B1, they have 50 MCQ from 65 minutes. Category B2, 50 MCQ from 65 minutes. And category module 4, electric fundamental. Category A, they don't want to do this one. Category B1, 20 MCQs and from 25 minutes. Category B2, 40 MCQs from 50 minutes. Module 5, digital techniques, electronic instruments and systems, kind of important module. So category A, they have 16 MCQs, 20 minutes, and category B1.1 and B1.3, they have 40 MCQ questions from 50 minutes, and category B1.2 and B1.4, they have 20 MCQs from 25 minutes, and category B2, 70 MCQs from 90 minutes. So B2, they have more questions, right? Okay, so module 6, material and hardware. Material and hardware is kind of important for the category B1 people. Okay, so the category A, they have 50 MCQs from 65 minutes. Category B1, 70 MCQs from 90 minutes. And category B2, 60 MCQs from 75 minutes. So module 7, maintenance practice. This module includes essays. Okay, category A, they have 70 MCQs and 2 essay questions. MCQ, they will give 90 minutes and 2 essay questions, they will give 40 minutes. And category B1, 80 MCQs and 2 essays, time is for 80 MCQs 100 minutes and 2 essay questions 40 minutes. And category B2, 60 MCQs and 2 essays, 60 MCQs, they will give 75 minutes and 2 essay questions 40 minutes. And module 8, basic aerodynamics. Basic aerodynamics is common to category A, B1 and B2, everyone, so they will each and every MCQ, 20 MCQs are given for each and every category and they will give 25 minutes for each and every MCQs, 20 MCQs. And module 9, human factors, category A, 20 MCQs, 1 essay questions, time for 25 minutes for 20 MCQs and 20 minutes for 1 essay question. And category B1, 20 MCQs and 1 essay questions, 25 minutes for 20 MCQs and 1 essay questions, they will give 20 minutes. Right, so category B2 also same like category A and category B1, 20 MCQs and unnecessary questions, and time is 25 minutes and 20 minutes. IVSA legislation. Category A, 30 MCQs and unnecessary questions are there, time allowed is 40 minutes for 30 MCQs and 20 minutes for unnecessary question. Category B1 also, category B1, they will get 40 MCQs and 1 essay questions and time allowed for 50 minutes for 40 MCQs and 20 minutes for 1 essay question. Category B2 also same like B1, 40 MCQs and 1 essay questions and time is 50 minutes for 40 MCQs and 20 minutes for 1 essay question. 11.8 is bit complicated modules and turbine, aeroplane, aerodynamic structures and systems. In this module they will define about the 80 chapters. And category A, 100 MCQs there, 145 minutes are there. And B1, 130 MCQs there, 165 minutes they will give. And B2, they don't want to do. And 11.B, it means 11B, piston, aeroplanes, aerodynamic structures and systems. Category A give 70 MCQs from 90 minutes, and category B1 100 MCQs from 125 minutes, and category B2 they don't want to do this one. Module 12 helicopter aerodynamics structures and systems, category A 90 MCQs 115 minutes, category B1 115 multiple choices from 145 minutes, and category B2 they don't want to do this one. Module 13 aircraft aerodynamics structures and systems, category A they don't want to do, category B1 also don't want to do, and category B2 130 multiple choices 165 minutes. Module 14 propulsions, category A they don't want to do, category B1 don't want to do, category B2 25 MCQs are there from 30 minutes. 15 I really like these modules, gas turbine. Category A 60 multiple choices 65 is kind of bit tricky, and category B1 90 MCQs are there, 150 minutes you will get, and category B2 they don't want to do this one. And 16 piston engine, category A they don't want to do, category B1 90 minutes are there, category B2 they also don't want to do. And module 17 propeller, category A they don't want to do, category B1 30 MCQs are there, 40 minutes is also a bit tricky, and category B2 they don't want to do. Okay, so these 17 modules, they will divide it into 3 levels, right? So this is called level 1, level 2, level 3. So knowledge levels, right? So let's get to know what are the levels and what are the, why they will divide these levels, right? For the level 1, familiarizations with the principal element of the subject. Objectives, the applicant should be familiar with the basic element of the subject, and the applicant should be able to give a sample description of the whole subjects using common words and examples. The applicant should be able to use typical terms. About level 2, a general knowledge of the theoretical and practical aspects of the subject, an ability to apply that knowledge and objectives is the applicant should be able to understand the theoretical fundamentals of the subject, and the applicant should be able to give a general descriptions of the subject using appropriate typical examples. The applicant should be able to use mathematical formula in conjunction with physical laws describing the subject. The applicant should be able to read and understand sketches, drawings and schematic description the subjects. The applicant should be able to apply his knowledge in a practical manner using detailed procedure. So level 3, the detailed knowledge of the theoretical and practical aspects of the subjects, the capacity to combine and apply the separate elements of the knowledge in a logical and comprehensive manner. Objectives, the applicant should know the theory of the subject and interrelationships with the other subjects. The applicant should be able to give a detailed description of the subject using theoretical fundamentals and specific examples. So level 3, also they have more. The applicant should understand and able to use mathematical formula related to the subjects, and the applicant should be able to read, understand and prepare sketches, some simple drawings and schematics describing the subject. The applicant should be able to apply his knowledge in a practical manner using manufacturer's instructions. The applicant should be able to interpret results from various sources and measurements and apply corrective actions where appropriate. Okay, so these are the subjects: module 1 mathematics, module 2 physics, module 3 electrical fundamentals, module 4 electronic fundamentals, 5 digital techniques, electronic instrument system, module 6 materials and hardware, 7 maintenance practices, 8 basic aerodynamics, 9 human factors, 10 aviation legislation, and 11 aeroplane aerodynamic structures and systems, jet engine. For module 11b for the piston engines, aeroplane aerodynamic structures and systems for the piston engines, and 12 helicopter aerodynamic structures and systems, 13 aircraft aerodynamics structures and systems, 14 propulsions, gas turbine engines, piston engines, propeller. So these are the license categories. So category A license, category B1 license, category B2 license. So category A license, aeroplane jet engines, they have to do 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 A and 15 and 17 jet engines. And aeroplane piston engines, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 B, 16 and 17 they have to do. Helicopter jet engines, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15. They have to do like this. You can see this graph. So in my channel, I will going to explain aeroplane jet engine procedures. sorry, aeroplane jet engines modules, and I will teach you each and every 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 15, and 17. I will give you small lessons for each and every one. Okay, I think you already got some information and knowledge about EASA Part 66 licensing and the process. So in next video, I'm going to give you some tutorials about module 1 mathematics, and you can stick with me for this lesson. And please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get more videos in future. Okay, thank you very much for staying with me, and let's meet on next video.